Hello and welcome back everybody to the European Challenger Series qualifiers. My name is Munchables and we're going to be jumping into theoretically the fifth game of the day. It's only been four games and to be honest, today has been soaring past. I feel like it's been a much shorter day than the other ones on this one, but we're going to be jumping straight into the action. I'm joined once again, of course, by Sona and X-Scoundrel will be helping me dissect some of the plays that we see here tonight. Now, Azus Rog up against Euronix. What do you guys think about this one on paper?
I mean, if you look at it from a purely analytical standpoint, it means very little in terms of Group A. In fact, every game now in Group A means very little because we've already decided who has gone through. So
I think tomorrow, like the Fnatic Academy versus...
I mean, in the grand standings of Group A in terms of who can actually qualify now, Euronix and Azus Rog, they are playing for pride at this point in time. It's essentially the Spanish qualifier team versus one of Germany's biggest teams, although they didn't come through the German League, they came through the open qualifier, but one of Germany's biggest teams. You know, they're going head-to-head here. Yep. I mean, you could maybe even see something fancy come through in Champions Select. It could just be a bit more of an entertaining game because it doesn't mean too much in terms of how each of these individual teams can perform.
I think something super important is the fact that Euronix was this team that we were heralding as one of the favorites. They were first place from the open qualifiers. They, in fact, qualified higher than Fnatic Academy from the open qualifiers. And we were expecting big things from this German team, but so far not really been able to deliver. Those two losses on the board already. And now, I think playing for pride, but also a conversation I was having with Sona earlier, also playing on a big stage right now. This is an opportunity.
I think the thing is, you have to remember as well, it's very easy to say Euronix haven't performed that well, Euronix haven't looked as strong as they could have done. They've played against Nerve and Fnatic Academy, and those are their two losses. Like it's the two teams that have come out of the group. Euronix are still an incredibly strong team. They still have some amazing members who stand out head and shoulders amongst some of the other players in that team, in that group. And I really think that you're underestimating them if you don't think they will be playing for pride and they will be playing to show themselves off to some degree.
I think what you're saying is important, though, because what you've mentioned is that the players themselves are fantastic. And this is now a big stage to show even just individual talent. Yeah. Like, although they play for their team right now, you know, there is that opportunity to showcase yourself as a potential CS caliber player. And you could be the guy that steps up and carries in this particular game. And you say, well, actually, I've still got what it takes to be at that level. You know, maybe not necessarily with Euronix, but I want to showcase us as a team, us as individual players, and that's what we're hoping to see.
Yeah, and not just in terms of CS scouting, but also LCS scouting. Like, a lot of these players in terms of mechanics are not that far away from the LCS players themselves. So we'll have to see if anyone does get picked up, but this is certainly going to be an interesting game, and I think we should talk about Azus Rog a little bit as well. Obviously, on the other side of the scoreboard, these guys, you know, they've not really been able to showcase too much so far in these games. It's not felt like they've had huge leads in any of the games. What do you think has been going wrong for Azus so far?
Just going to say, again, I think it's important to note the teams they played against. So they played against LDLC, Nerve, and Fnatic Academy, which is not the easiest
thing.
You're in Group A, you play against all of those teams. Like, that's actually what happens, right?
I agree, but I think it's very easy to say this team hasn't really performed that well or hasn't really shown up.
Because they haven't.
But you forget the fact that they played against some very tough opponents. I think day one, Azus Rog didn't look strong, but day two and day three, Azus Rog showed us some signs of brilliance. Livesan on that, Syndra played very well. Eco has looked incredible on Rek'Sai a lot of the week as well. So the thing I'm trying to do here is I'm trying to show that just because a team's gone 0-3 or goes, you know, 0-5 in a group, it doesn't mean that they're not full of great players. It just means that perhaps the other teams had slightly better macro play or understood the patch a little bit better. I'm trying to be magnanimous. I think these guys are great players.
I'm going to stop you there because you're being Mr. Nice Guy. You're in a competition right now. This competition is for the Challenger Series qualification. If you want to be at Challenger Series level, you have to be beating this level of teams. You are 0-3, you are not the best team in this group.
I had wanted a light conversation on the topic. I am going to steer away from this before it becomes a full-on domestic. Ash, Caitlyn, and Varus have been banned out on Euronix, and Syndra and Camille banned out for Azus Rog so far. What do we think of the last ban, guys?
Let's have a look. Lee Sin, Rengar, any of the jungle bans coming through could be ideal. Ryze is actually targeted here. Magi Felix is not going to get his hands on that.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's all AD carry bans from Euronics. They're looking for a very specific AD pick here. It could be the Vayne. I think Jhin is also there as a possibility. Vayne does work out well, but first pick in Vayne doesn't really make a huge amount of sense because the enemy team just counteracts it a lot. But I would probably go Jhin here as your remaining AD carry.
It does go back to the point, though, of, well, Katarina going to be the first pick here. It goes back to the point of, you know, this game in the grand schemes of the tournament doesn't have any influence on placing. So maybe just have a bit of fun. Maybe show off a champion that you actually just want to play.
Exactly. I mean, Yoppa has had a tough time. Look, we would argue that Yoppa probably has been one of the weaker players from Aces Rogue, and I think he has shown elements of weakness in the top lane. Had a good game on Poppy the other day, but realistically has been a lane that has been difficult for Aces Rogue to find headway in. Maybe just put Yoppa back on something like his Fiora and say, look, I mean, we know that you're a great Fiora player, although you didn't have success with it 100% in this early portion of the tournament. We know you like the more carry-orientated roles. Just go crazy this game. I mean, really just take that kind of risk.
I think you've got to have fun with it, haven't you? That's what you're like. It's about showing off who are your best champs and why you play them well and why you were picked for this team in the first place. I like the Yasuo because we've seen Yoppa play it before, actually do it really well for TCA, I believe. Alongside that, the Lee Sin synergizes well. Lee Sin, obviously one of the meta junglers at the moment. It's not an AD carry, but it looks like it is just going to be a more traditional composition coming out here for Aces Rogue.
A little bit disappointed, almost.
I'm slightly disappointed.
But, you know,
mate, Poppy mid lane, Lee Sin, AP support, just you wait.
It does go back to the point that we were making earlier, that this is a very important tournament in terms of who's watching. Like, yeah, these absolutely. Players are on a big stage and they're wanting to prove themselves. So I think playing to the meta is fairly appropriate. Ivan and Kled, we say playing to the meta, all of the Euronics picks so far have been very fringe
meta. I mean, Kled is specifically picked into Poppy in a lot of situations. Ivan has seen some play and has remained relevant over the last few months in various situations. And Katarina, like you said, is kind of fringe pick right here in the mid lane. Yeah. It's been banned a couple of times. I haven't really seen a Katarina pop off yet, but I'm sure when we do, we'll see why it's been getting banned. Euronics look like they're just here to say, well, We are here to have fun this time, right? You know, and also we're going to win lane, look to win lane from that, and a bit of a different composition that we've kind of seen them run with in previous games.
I'm trying to remember who picked Kled last time.
It was Euronics.
Was it Euronics phones. Again? Was it Phones
yeah,
again?
Yeah, okay. Phones.
So yeah, we've seen him play it once before. It did work out well for them at times, although of course, I think they ended up losing the game, didn't they?
No, they
won. Did they win it?
I think they won, right?
It might have been their one ring. I'm going to have a quick look while you guys continue to talk about things.
Okay, and now we have Taric and Twitch locked in here for Euronics.
Wow.
So you're talking about fringe picks right now. This is a fringe composition.
Right, I'm not sure that's fringe, to be honest. I think that's
off
just
meta.
Straight up breaking the meta. Yeah. Going for Taric and Twitch. I mean, Twitch in solo queue has been obscenely good recently.
Yeah, a lot of players popularizing Twitch jungle and Twitch top. Very little Twitch AD carry. But yeah, Twitch top and Twitch jungle has been seeing some popularity.
So you are right. It was the game they won against Babaski when they played it. I just trying to like theory craft around the Twitch here. You have got the Ivan who can Bushmaker. You stand in that. You pop down the Rat-a-tat-tat or that Spray and Pray as we now affectionately call it because that's what it's called. Taric there with the invulnerability
it's been
as well.
Back to Spray and Pray.
God, right? The Taric there with the invulnerability and then the Kled for the engage, you can actually have the opportunity of just winning out a team fight because the enemy can't see you that much because you're dodging around in these bushes. However, Rogue's team just looks a little bit more meta. They have picked Orianna AD carry, so perhaps not as meta as it was going to be. But no, that's it. That's the pick the block and Orianna AD
carry. That's Orianna AD carry, right. Okay.
Empowered also attacks, boys.
It does kind of go in the same theory as like Ziggs AD carry in that you can push the lane very, very hard. You don't have the same tower crushing ability.
That's the reason you pick Ziggs though. The whole reason of Ziggs is that you queue the wave and then you just push the tower and take the tower incredibly quickly. Orianna, like, she has empowered autos, but so do AD carries.
And Ziggs passive applies to towers, right? You can get the extra damage.
Short
to towers
fuse can get you extra damage.
Satchel charge.
Yeah, and also you have moderately low mana costs on your Q. And Orianna actually chunks through mana in the early game trying to push waves as effectively as she can. She's actually pretty poor at early levels at pushing waves. I guess Aces Rogue
saw... Could you say that maybe this isn't a serious pick?
You could maybe
would
say...
Would we be willing to go that far?
I would be willing
to theory craft it. I think we should go... Let's think it's super serious, right?
All right, I'm getting
and
the
then
book.
We
it's actually Sona's book.
So my thought is, right, Orianna's shield against Twitch means that you don't take as much tick damage, number one. Number two, you've got the Zyra there as well, so you've got Stranglethorns into Shockwave, which keeps everyone inside the Stranglethorns, which means you get the knock-up as well. Twitch has relatively long range. I'm not 100% sure Orianna's going to match him in the lane.
See, the problem with this...
Right? I can't
this
theory... Is, it's bad.
One
it's,
of the yeah, biggest issues with League of Legends theory crafting like this is you're creating this perfect scenario that happens in this perfect game where everything, all of the stars happen to align and all of the ultimates happen to perfectly wombo combo. That happens in one in every 1,000 games or so. Like, it's never quite that black and white right. In terms of we have good ultimates that work together, theoretically.
So LeBlanc should... theoretically destroy Katarina in lane.
Yeah.
Like, Katarina Demolisher. Shouldn't be able to deal with LeBlanc. So I think a lot of what you're seeing here is kind of almost like, I want to win my lane, because Kled into Poppy is, I want to win my lane. That's why you pick Kled into Poppy. You want to shut her down. LeBlanc into Katarina is, I want to win my lane. Twitch Taric is an interesting one, because that is very anti-tower dive, so you always have that backup of the invulnerability should you be on the receiving end of a tower dive. And when the siege starts to take place as the levels go up, Orianna and Zyra should push a Taric, and even regardless of later levels, Orianna and Zyra should push a Taric Twitch into turret.
Do you want to know the really interesting thing about this? Because in a minute you're going to ask us our predictions. And what I'm going to say to you, Munch, is... Up until LeBlanc was locked in, I was going Aces Rogue all the way, because it's a coherent team composition. It makes a lot of sense. You pick a normal AD carry alongside that. Fine, pick a Jhin, right? Instead, I have to go with a Tonic that is Euronics gaming lineup, which is a composition I disagree with inherently within my soul, but I think it's going to win.
In your soul?
Deep in my soul, okay. I disagree with this composition, but I think it's going
to
win.
To be honest, I wouldn't be surprised if you were giving me different reasons right there. I think outside of the draft, like if we were talking about these two teams, Euronics, I mean, you were the one that was defending these teams, saying like, look, Euronics are a phenomenal team. They've just had
but he also said that phenomenal Aces Rock are a team. Phenomenal team.
I said we've seen signs of brilliance from Aces Rock. I don't think consistently they've been a good team.
It's the tiptoeing on eggshells approach that Sony's taking.
It's called being
backpedaling. It's called backpedaling.
Being nice sometimes. Like these guys, you can't disagree that Eco and Livesan at points have looked great.
Every team in this competition is a high level competitive team that would wipe me across the floor every day of the week. But there's no arguing that Aces Rogue have looked the weakest group, the weakest team in their group.
That's why I didn't talk about the team, I talked about the players.
So all of the players are very good. And you know, we've seen Yoppa in the ESL UK Premiership. He was a fantastic top laner for, I believe, TCA when he was playing. Yeah. So, you know, a lot of the players individually are fantastic. But again, you don't win games by being a great individual player. Although maybe you could speak to Faker, but he's got a great team around him as well. So, you know,
I was going to say, it's a difficult one to argue, to be quite honest. But I'm going to ask you for predictions.
Can I predict none of them?
We'll start with you, Sona.
Can I predict everyone loses?
Since you've already had a bit of a tirade.
About 30 seconds ago, I told you I was going to pick ESG, and I'm going to stick with the ESG pick.
Okay, Exandro.
Can I pick everyone loses?
No.
ESG.
ESG, okay. Do you know what? Just to spice things up a little bit, I'm going to go with Aces Rock.
As if we needed a more spicy game.
Yeah, you guys have a very spicy game.
I figure of all of the games that you really can't predict how it's going to go, this is going to be it. So Aces Rock is going to be my pick on this one. We'll see how it's going to pan out. I mean, let's try and analyze these compositions a little bit more seriously. Let's take a look at the ESG composition, because that one's a little bit more... kind of serious-ish.
Sure.
I mean, other than the Twitch and Taric, all of those champions have been picked in previous games.
Okay, so you've got a great split push with Kled. Always is going to, throughout the game, be a monster against Poppy. So you've always got that element to your kit. Ivan and Taric with a Twitch, plenty of shielding, plenty of protection. You've got good peel for the Twitch. Keeping Twitch invulnerable during spray and pray is a great situation to be in. Huge team-wide damage coming out from that. And then you add the Katarina in. While people are so obsessed with Twitch, Katarina can be, you know, that destructive force in the backline. Or even you just make Katarina invulnerable during that sort of ultimate phase. Suddenly you get basically free Death Lotus if you time it correctly. So there is... synergistic approaches here, although I wouldn't say the siege is very good. Tower dive potentially with the invulnerability, but it's difficult to make time working. So you've got good split push and then some element of a cohesive team fight that could work. Probably easier to pull off than this weird combo that Sona's talking about with the Orianna.
I don't think so. Like, you look at the rest of that composition. So on the other side, you're looking at Aces Rock. Lee Sin, easy to isolate a single target. So you're looking at isolating, you know, the Twitch or the Taric or the Katarina, whichever one you want. Orianna does have okay base damage on her auto attacks, although I disagree with it being AD carry. I think
maybe it's AD Orianna.
That's what I was thinking. I still disagree with that.
So I think we've been barking up the wrong tree with how this composition plays out. It's the logic of AD carry isn't that good right now. Let's have a strong AD jungler, have an AD top laner, and just have two AP carries.
I wouldn't count Poppy as an AD top laner. I know she does physical damage, but she doesn't give you enough AD. I guess you could argue you can go double AP because magic resist is quite difficult to buy. So you've only got Spirit Visage and Banshees alongside Locket, which, you know, no longer gives you that magic resist aura. I do think it's going to be AD carry Orianna, in all honesty. I can see where you're coming from with the AP, but I just think AD just makes a little bit more sense, even though it doesn't make a lot of sense anyway.
I think what's more important to look at is how I don't think the Aces Rogue composition works well into the invulnerability and shielding coming through from the Taric and the Ivern, because, you know, if you can time things correctly and Taric lands invulnerability, shields go down on key targets, you've got burst, and that's all you've got, right? You've got no real sustained damage coming out from the Aces Rogue army. Zyra plants potentially, but
I think the argument is, though, that you burst them before that ultimate comes down. It takes 2.5 seconds for Taric, I believe, to come down. It might be 2 seconds, but still, it takes a long time. So you're going to burst them before
they get the ultimate down. You've got the shield and the Bastion.
One Trigger Seed isn't really going to do too much. I think you can burst them before Trigger Seed gets fairly hefty
at some point. Also, you've got Bastion as well. So
yeah. I love how this is probably one of the best conversations in terms of which team composition is better, and it's the one that is just completely
the thing is, though, the team I'm arguing is better is the team I've argued against for my predictions, so I can't really say too much. I'm playing devil's advocate to some degree. I think if you look at it purely as a coherent composition, ESGs makes more sense just because you can see the defined role for each hero, each champion. On the side of Aces Rogue, I really dislike the Orianna pick. Apart from that, I like the rest of their composition.
If you land a Shockwave, you do set up LeBlanc nicely, though.
And if you land a Stranglethorns, you set up LeBlanc nicely.
Yeah.
And if you land a good Hammer Smash and knock a couple of people away, and if you land a Lee Sin Kick. But it's what Munch is saying. You can't assume that everything is going to work out perfectly for you.
Let's take this theoretical concept, right? LeBlanc stomps lane. If you set LeBlanc up, you could have this winning ingredient.
Well, why don't we take this theoretical concept live onto the Summoner's Rift?
Wow, you just ruined Munch's transition.
Brutal. It's fine. I get to cast the game, so no worries. And to be honest, I'm pretty happy to be casting this one. Of all of the compositions, this is what we're looking at. And I'm curious now to see how this one's going to pan out in the early game, whether we have a little bit more aggression than what we've been seeing previously, because we've certainly not got the same compositions we've been seeing. Wouldn't be surprised to see an entirely different play style as well. What do you reckon, Scoundrel?
I honestly couldn't tell you, my friend. But we are seeing the the Doran's Ring come out on Orianna early on here. So maybe straying away from Sona's potential AD carry Orianna theory. Because you could play it more likely like the Ziggs would, and, you know, just... Yeah. But the problem is you are lacking in AD damage unless Lee Sin gets rolling on Eco, and then he does get to a sort of a heavy Black Cleaver-esque build, maybe go down to Momora Mortius.
I would love to see the Orianna hovered by the Observer, just so I can see whether there's AP on the rune page, because that will tell us for sure what the build is actually going to look like. But obviously, we have a clean feed, so I can't actually communicate. Here we go, though. Bit of cheese in the bottom lane. Rafa has been locked up. Might just have to flash on this one. Expunge isn't quite enough to finish off the kill. Sanchez actually trying to return a good amount of damage.
You trade very well as Orianna with just a basic attack trade because you have that wind-up passive.
Yeah. As long as you're focusing on that same target over and over again, yeah. Oh, flashes forward. That is going to be first blood. I asked if it was going to be more aggression. There absolutely has been. Sanchez is in trouble. Expunge finishes off the kill, or Contaminate, or whatever they called it these days. I can't keep up with the Twitch name changes.
And that's why you don't pick Orianna in the bot lane, because she literally can do nothing at level one. And that's a nice setup. It was all set up, obviously. If that hadn't been Rafa walking into a stun, then we wouldn't have seen this situation occur. But Orianna, although the basic attack trades are great, don't really have anything else going for you. And what a great early start here for your Onyx Gaming. Munch, how confident are you feeling?
What are my predictions? Not overly, to be honest.
Not overly confident, my
friend. Considering there's a 10 CS lead in the bottom lane, and it's Ariane against a zero CS. But we'll have to wait and see.
Oh, I'm going to have a great time this game.
I believe in Econators. I reckon he can snowball that bottom lane in his favor. Ariana grabbing a couple of CS.
Obvious looking to gank.
He certainly is. Imagine Felix jumping forward, but not really quite able to get onto that target. So nothing going to be gleaned from that one.
LeBlanc, slippery custom. Oh, we got a pause.
There it
just
is.
As Katarina is about to hit a CS, I'm going to have to sit back down, I'm afraid.
That's okay, mate.
That's a really annoying noise.
Horrendously annoying noise. Dear me. Well, what do you reckon of the game so far? Were you expecting that level one cheese down at the bottom lane?
Yeah, you're a Twitch and Taric. I mean, if you can make it happen, make it happen. I mean, Twitch has got a fantastic level one. That's why Twitch with Ignite top tended to be a thing. You kind of like waiting for them to sometimes face check you and just land those basic attacks, stack up that passive and get that contaminate / expunge. I think it's contaminate, but I can't remember.
I think it's contaminate.
But with a Taric, and especially against such a squishy target like Zyra, you know, you don't know whether Orianna's taking command attack or command protect first. If she's taking command protect, you might have had a better chance of surviving, but I don't believe she did. And they walked straight into the trap.
They certainly did, and I mean, the rest is history. Two kills right at
the
start of
the
game.
The rest is 2 minute old history.
It's still history, that still counts. But yeah,
just going to write in my history book, 1 second.
Phenomenal start. Get away from my pen, sir.
What, really?
Phenomenal start there for
it's okay, I've got
Euronix. I mean, it's difficult to analyze when you get thrown into a pause that's 2 minutes into a bit of a Clan Fiesta game. There's not a whole lot of directions that you can take the conversation. I mean, I can talk to you about narrative if you would like. Euronix, they want this win to prove themselves. They've, as Sona said, they've gone against hard opponents to start things off. And now they're kind of trying to pick up the pieces a little bit with this Cedria Noxiac God combo of Twitch and Taric.
Well, the CS has been firmly caught up, actually. 9 CS now over to Sanchez. So he's managed to regain some posture in that bot lane, but what a start. Eco now looking to come down. There's no summoners here for Euronix, and Eco is ready to make some magic happen.
Yeah, straight onto Noxiac there, lands the Sonic Wave as well. Good bit of damage, but it's not quite enough to finish the job. Cedrian actually trying to trade the damage straight on back. Magic Felix versus Livsian in the mid lane. He's going to get first blood, except it's not the first kill of the game. Magic Felix, though, getting a solo kill.
He gets third blood. What a play.
Did get a solo kill, though.
Yeah, I mean, that's surprising. I was expecting LeBlanc to have an easier time of it here, but apparently Magi Felix proving me wrong, finding the solo kill on the Katarina and escaping with a sliver of life under turret. But LeBlanc has the teleport, will find her way easily back into the lane, and should be able to regain some composure.
Oh, here comes Obvious down into this bottom lane. No rest for the Wicked when it comes to Rafa and Sanchez, but Obvious not quite able to make anything out.
No, actually, Phones struggling against Yoppa here. An interesting turn of events as Kled generally is picked into the Poppy to have an easier time of things.
Oh, he's doing all right in this trade specifically. That's basically all of the lead Yoppa had completely taken away now. Bear trap on a rope will not quite land though. Yoppa in a bit of a bad spot here if Phones can keep up the pressure, but he's baited Phones in. It turns out there was a jungler around all along, and it's going to be a kill going the way of Yoppa.
And he gets the cheeky shield at the end there because the flying buckler picked up the kill for Yoppa at the start, and Asus ROG will be happy they've managed to level out some pressure in the lanes because everything seems to be going against them. Let's look at this.
Yeah,
Magi Felix.
He has got that reset and will pick up the kill. Magic Felix doing a good job on this Katarina, and this is what you pick it for. You want those solo kills. You want to just be incredibly aggressive. And to be quite honest, this is feeling an awful lot like spectating solo queue right now.
I mean, this is worse than solo queue. You've got an Orianna AD carry.
I don't know what your solo queue experience is like, but this is exactly what I have to deal with.
I'm arguably the worst dealer of Diamond 5.
Well, here we go, Rafa. Once again, getting stunned up here. Contaminate stacking up Noxiac. Jumping a bit aggressive there, but well, had to back away in the end. Cedrian did get low, but no real threat of danger.
Looks like Eco could be heading back towards this top lane to put pressure onto Phones, who's taken low again. Yoppa's setting this one up.
Yeah, and still has his charge, I believe, on this one. Phones Nowhere to run. Will get
oh, wait a second.
Skull back, but he might be looking for a 2v1. Gets one onto Ikonatus, and now he's looking for Yopper, who's running with his little yodel tail between his legs. Good amount of damage still in Phone's kit if he can just fight the targets, but doesn't manage to land his shotgun blast, and Yopper might be able to turn this one around. Again, charges on down. Hammer smash will finish off the kill. One for one, all things considered. Cedrian does get ignited on down. Noxiac underneath the tower, tanking up a little bit too much damage. Obvious though, saves his life with a trigger seeded.
Goodbye.
Here comes the Katarina. Magic Felix sweeps up a kill.
What is going on, Munchables? There is kills left, right, and center. Phones couldn't stack that bravery, I believe. Courage. Courage is the right word. Couldn't stack that courage because he just recently regained his Raptor. But again, Cedrian just stood in front of those Zyroplans, took a little bit too much punishment. But again, Magic Felix able to sweep things up on that Katarina in the bot lane. Will lose a bit of pressure in that mid lane, but I'm sure he'll be comfortable with that, trading another kill. Picks up a Hex Drinker, and probably now moving towards what I assume is going to be his Hextech Gunblade.
Yeah, would not be surprised to see that next. That's usually the one we see come out first, Katarina, but I think just playing so that Livsian can't get him in a singular combo. Phones looking to get onto Ikonatus, doesn't quite get the chain though. Magic Felix just going to be Dragon Raged away, which means Ikonatus happily walks away with that buff.
Yeah, he walks away with it. He does use the Dragon Rage kick though, so you do. Oh my word, Noxiac is aggressive here.
Yeah, but misses the stun, so Rafa walking away to start with gets a shield as well, so they're not going to be able to push for that one. Noxiac maybe a little bit overzealous with the push.
I think you can tell that these players are enjoying the game. Yeah. They're having a good time here. Looks like the blue buff is the target. Magic Felix going in, knowing there's no way of stopping him.
Yeah, Magic Felix will get locked up though. Livsian exhausted, but it's not going to make a difference to the damage. Daisy comes on through as Trigger Seed procs onto Magic Felix. Livsian jumps over the wall. He'll be able to pull himself to safety once more. Rafa though has been found out by Cedrian and might just go down to the Contaminate, which he does. So there's another kill going the way of Euronix. Now Yopper being chased on down by Phones, who's looking for this kill onto the Poppy, but he's just never quite able to find it.
No, he needs another bear trap on the rope to finish this one off. But again, Poppy with the... Daisy's looking for a tower dive now.
Yep, the Trigger Seed going to slow down Sanchez, and Obvious charging on in, but he's tanking the tower. Needs to be careful on that one. One more shot would have finished him, but Yopper actually forcing Phones to tank a tower as well. And Yopper, once again, winning out that fight. Actually ults the minions there in joy.
Just got to, you know, assert your dominance sometimes. And Yopper proceeded to right there. And then looks like Daisy's now going to be able to pressure this tier 1 turret in the bot lane. Very early take here for Euronix as Eco continues his attempt at the counter jungle. You can see Phones trying to be overly aggressive against Yopper, fed the Poppy now 3 kills. There will become a point where he probably won't win the 1v1. I mean, it looks like he's been winning it thus far. The tower did some good work for Yopper there in that engage.
I've got to say, this isn't the most serious game I've ever cast in my career.
Is it not?
No.
It's definitely the most serious game I've ever cast.
Really?
Yeah, I'm
fairly confident. Is this your first day?
I'm pretty confident in my analysis of that. I've never seen a more serious game of League of Legends in my life.
I'm struggling to believe you right now, Excoundrel. You're breaking the trust that this friendship is built on.
We're friends?
I don't know. Maybe. I'm acting for the viewers, you know.
Oh, yeah. You want to give the pretense that we are close compadres.
Yeah, that companionship is what drives the viewers' hearts. Maybe it doesn't. You tell me. Tweet with the hashtag EUCS and let us know.
Let us know if it's friendship that
Magic drives Felix
us.
Is in trouble though. Dragon Rage lands Sonic Wave as well, but flashes away from the tether. And we'll be able to walk away with his life. Maybe going back in though. Trigger Seed means he gets the reset instantly. Livsian's in trouble because Phones has jumped right onto his face and slices him open. Fantastic turnaround there from Euronix.
That is some descriptive commentary there, my friend.
Well, that's Kled, isn't it? He's vicious.
My mental imagery when you came up with that concoction of words was pretty grim.
All right, well, Sanchez now going to be the next one in trouble. Good shockwave keeps him alive for a millisecond, but Magic Felix shampoos to victory. And now pressure onto this mid lane tower. This is getting out of control very quickly for ROG. They have a 5,000 gold deficit at 11 minutes into the game. And actually, Euronix They've got a kill for every minute so far, and they're looking to turn it into more as Yoppa is not going to get stunned. Nice flash coming out from him at the last second there, but Cedrian has arrived on the scene. Rat-a-tat-tat is not the name of his ultimate anymore, but it is going to push the wave on forward so they can look for that tower.
Yeah, and even despite the two teleports, Euronics still come on top in that siege. They haven't yet finished off the tower, and actually it looks like Aces Rog are doing their best job to stop it from taking place. Now Cedrian trying to sneak in here. Can he achieve the submarine twitch?
He's not going to find anyone just yet. Bones is going to be the first one to go down, but Magic Felix is looking for a reset. Can't quite get the kill onto the jungler as Yoppa jumps in onto Cedrian. That's going to be two kills going the way of Aces Rog. A good little bit of play from them. And might actually get some pressure onto this mid lane tower since health bars are so low.
Yeah, they were also potentially looking for some counter jungling, but I think you'll find that Eco will have no joy. Only the Krugs left available on that red side jungle, which he will end up going for here. ESG need to be careful though, they did accrue a fairly sizable lead that has been chunked down through a couple of kills here. And if they lose this tier 1 in the mid lane, they will have lost all of that sort of momentum they had gained on the previous siege. All teleports down now means it could be a little bit easier for ESG to mount some sort of attempt at pushing onto this tier 1 in the mid though. But again, 5-0 on your Katarina, that's not the kind of scoreline you'd want to see if you were Aces Rock.
You're absolutely correct. Huge gold leads across the board right now for Euronics. Aside from that top lane, it's all about Yoppa in this game, but it's difficult to really carry on Poppy. It doesn't have the damage to really win out those fights single-handedly. You can enable others to carry, but not so much yourself.
And I think actually Bones knows he's probably in a position where going into this Poppy will be difficult for him to trade. It's a Ninja Tabi and a Sunfire Cape at this point in time. Poppy will likely be able to sustain through the majority of the damage being thrown at her. And Phones knows that he's probably best off just attempting to clear waves at this point in time.
Obvious, just gonna take away the blue buff. Obviously, you can do it near instantly when you're playing on Ivern.
If you've got Smite, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. If you set up Friend of the Forest and then smite the minion, you will get the buff instantly. And also, you get to give it to a friend as well, so nice little bit of team play coming out. Phones now in a whole heap of trouble. That is going to be Ekonators and Rafa entering the fray. Eco grabbing that kill for himself. And that is going to mean that Yoppa can get some serious pressure in the top lane. In the meantime, though, Euronics, they're pressuring the tier 2 in this mid lane.
Yeah, but they did leave that option open as the tier 1 was so low, and ESG were grouped around that mid lane. Looks like this is going to be a very quick and simple take here on the siege. LeBlanc jumping in.
Yeah, Lipsian trying to do some damage to Cedrian, but he will get away with his life on that one. And now Rafa actually getting engaged on by Magic Felix. It's the trigger seat blocking a lot of damage. And Euronics, they get away with murder on that one. Walk away for free. And they trade two towers for one.
Yeah, ASG. I've got a slight tower advantage reflected in a fairly small gold lead. It was 5,000 gold early on before they made that misplay in the mid lane. Now down to around 3,000. Katarina has finished up the Hextech Gunblade that's been done for a little bit. She's now heading towards what looks to be potentially Mercury Treads. Ivan, early item in Redemption here. Looks like Redemption is going to be the first item for the Taric too. So double Redemption potentially coming through for the Euronics Gaming lineup. That makes sense. You know, you want to prevent as much damage as possible. If LeBlanc can't find that assassination on her first skill rotation, it limits what she can do in a team fight. Plus, the shields from Taric and the shields from Ivan both benefit from the Redemption passive bonus. So it makes a lot of sense that this would be the item choice that they are looking for.
Yoppa charging for Cedrian right now. The stun onto both members, though. Nice play by Noxiac to deny the engage onto his AD carry. I mean, they walk away without a fear of death in their hearts.
We haven't really talked much about the Orianna AD carry at this point in time. She's actually had a pretty decent time of it. Bones.
A little bit of trouble there. Lipsian does have some serious damage, but Obvious will be able to keep his top laner alive, and the teleport does get cancelled in the end.
Magic Felix now backing off. Can't Shunpo to Blast Cone, but can't Shunpo to Wars. Yoppa's now the target here for Cedrian, but he's got a lot of armor and a lot of shield to burn through. And I don't think Yoppa's that bothered right now.
Yoppa, aggressive flash, will walk away to safety in the end. I think he could have just gone round, but You know, Yoppa's not that kind of guy.
It's about sending a message, dude. We've talked about this before. Sometimes you just need to put your foot down and say, this is my lane. And that's what Yoppa did right there.
Yeah, but still not really. I'm not sure if it is his lane. Here we go. Teleport, though, coming out from Livsian. They're looking to make something happen. Yoppa has to back away, though. Stun doesn't quite land. Noxiac fairly low on HP. And both teleports cancelled once again.
And Cedric is now just pushing this way. This is what they will have against the Poppy in some respects. That push that the Twitch has against him. Here comes the redemption.
Yoppa fairly low. Four members up in this top lane, though, now. So Euronics, you would imagine, should get some pressure onto this tower. Imagine Felix managing to dodge away from that Sonic Wave, and that means that should scare away the Aegis Rogue members. And this will be the fourth tower of the game for Euronics. Starting to build a hefty lead for themselves. That'll push the gold lead to about 5,000 once again. Gonna be very happy with that one. In fact, slightly less, about 4,000 so far.
Orianna's hit the Morellonomicon. She's going towards an Aether Wisp as well, so you know, she's got the cooldown reduction, mana regeneration is there. This is kind of what Ziggs would have taken first if we had a Ziggs AD carry. Starting to push waves out at this point in time. You know, you are starting to see some potential behind the Orianna AD carry.
You know, theoretically, I don't hate the idea of double AP carry as long as you have a strong AD jungler and, you know, AD damage in the top lane. The thing is, it doesn't really work out too well when both of your AP carries are 0 and 3. That's where the plan really starts to fall.
It also depends where Lee Sin or Ico is going to go with his build path after this. I'm glad that he's going towards Black Cleaver, because that's what we talked about with being a potential saving grace for them. If they have that strong AD that can win in the mid game, you know, you can always have an AD threat here. Against it, realistically, the person that you're mainly looking to take out early is Twitch, and then you can deal with potentially Katarina after. I want to see where Katarina decides to go after this, however.
Yoppa in a 1 versus 2 right now, but they've yet to break through his shield.
Doing no damage.
Yeah, happy to keep this one going. Imagine Felix actually in a fair bit of trouble right now. If Yoppa could just keep this one up, Redemption will heal Imagine Felix pretty significantly, though. And actually, Yoppa might have just bitten off more than he can chew on this one. He's all alone, and suddenly there are four enemies to be dealing with. Slow comes down from Twitch. He's going to be stacking up that damage over time, and there's a final stun. All that's needed for Magic Felix to pick up his sixth kill of the game.
Still, it took, by my count, about 25 seconds and four members to kill a Poppy with just two items and a Ninja Tabi. But they're still going in onto Cedrian here.
Poor Sanchez, all alone in the world and no one to save him. He's going to go down. Cedrian grabs the kill for himself, and now they can look towards a mid lane, potentially Inhibitor. This is a very aggressive push in 19 minutes.
I like the what we saw from Taric and Twitch there. That's kind of what we talked about in stopping the potential of an Orianna. The Stranglethorns comes out to buy time, but Daisy is doing a good job of tanking. Redemption comes through. We could have a fight here.
Certainly could. Econator's trying to find a way into the fight, but immediately chased off. And now Euronics looking for a way out of this one. Nice little charge there from Phones just to try and stop Yoppa in his tracks, and will be able to do so with the help of Obvious.
Still, and well, forcing a teleport. Didn't get too much out of that push, though. There was a good idea from them, but again, death timers are so low at 19 minutes that you have to be, you know, already set up to achieve an objective like an inhibitor turret if you just make one pick.
So Cloudrake on the map right now. Neither team really has given any notice to the Drake so far. Still got a Rapper there, but Yoppa taking the tower for literally days. And finally starting to take damage from that. Noxiac has been pinned against the wall. Might just get finished off. Flash does come on through, gets a shield for himself, but the stun at the last second, as well as a trigger seat, might just keep him alive. Yoppa's going to keep chasing that one.
Magic Felix
with a double kill for himself. Managing to sweep that fight up, and now Yoppa, barely any mana remaining, but it's just so darn tanky.
Yeah, but this is going to take another good 17 years of my life to see Poppy die here.
Cedrian is there. As long as Cedrian doesn't take too much damage, they'll be absolutely fine. And in the meantime, we do see Econator might just get a kill onto Magic Felix. This actually, if they can get a few auto attacks in, this could be a mid lane tower. The rotation shouldn't be quick enough to stop this one. But can they escape? That's the question. Econator's just noticed that there's an entire enemy team chasing him. And I don't know if he gets away with this one, to be quite honest. Bone's going to be chasing him on.
He's got charge
through
up soon. was going to say charge. I feel like every time you mention his ultimate, you must talk about it in that sort of respect.
I would have, but I don't know if you watched the champion spotlight, but it was arguably the cringiest thing I've ever seen. So
potentially, actually.
I can't commit to it anymore.
All right, okay. Sorry, buddy.
Sorry, Freak, but it was painful.
I'm sure Freak's devastated by that comment.
I'm sure he is. Here we go, though. Fight going on at Blue Buff. As the Blue Buff is going to be taken away, smited by Econators in the end. So Aces Rock keeping hold of those little advantages. 3,000 gold is the difference right now.
It's practically nothing, buddy.
To be honest, in 10 minutes' time, you'd be right. But 3,000 gold in 20 minutes is...
to lead.
It's significant. It is. It does matter. Certainly, and that is going to be a Cloud Drake as well, picked up for Euronix Gaming. So they get a cheeky bit of movement speed.
What the item is greyed out, and I can't see. Oh, it's a more of Malmortius. So Katarina has decided to go down a more AD orientated route, and she looks like she's building more into AD. I mean, I have seen this. I have seen AD Katarina from time to time. So
yeah, it can work. And phones. Heading to mid lane, mate. You can take an inhibitor here if you help your team out. He's actually going to charge on through, aiming at Rafa right there. Backs away in the end, appropriately so, but the zoning is there, and this is going to mean an inhibitor goes the way of Euronix Gaming. This could be bad news, or in fact, it is bad news for Aces Rog Army. Bad news for my prediction score.
I'm sorry, buddy. You know, I know it must hurt. You got two wrong today. Actually, three wrong, including Forge.
I think the painful thing is actually... I just wanted to vote differently.
Yeah. You would have... If you were voting with your brain, you would have gone... You would have gone for it. Because they've got a real AD carry. It's awesome.
That is true. Well, Yopper has been caught up, but as we've said a few times, he is very, very tanky. With the all five members, though, go down fairly quickly. Knocks Seac on this front line. We'll get tethered as well, but the knock-up from Stranglethorns doesn't quite connect. Daisy, no! Is going to go down in the end.
50 Daisy! Hit.
50 gold into Econator's pocket. He's certainly not a vegetarian.
And well, it's a cake.
Yeah, but it's all about plants and trees and loving nature and stuff.
Right,
that's the reference I was trying to make. Imagine Felix is in trouble right now. Trigger Seed will save his life, though. Take a look at that Trigger Seed, Sonex. Not as feeble as you keep saying.
Another redemption comes through here, and suddenly, Euronix Gaming are healthy once more. Looks like a Baron has been started, though, by Aces Rog, trying to do it with just the Zyra plants. And actually, Euronix have no idea this is taking place. Are Aces Rog even in a position where they can do this?
I'm not sure. Sanchez is... also there to do damage. Yopper can tank it indefinitely, and here comes Econator and Lipsia.
They're going to get it.
They're actually going to get away
get
with this one. Aces Rog with the turnaround play. Sneak a Baron away from Euronix.
Well, if you needed something to get you back into the game, and Baron certainly is a good starting point, and now they are just 1,500 gold behind their opposition.
That's really pretty much nothing at this point in the game, to be quite honest. And, well, while they lack an AD carry for Siege...
So 4 minutes ago, 3,000 was significant, but now at 24 minutes 45 in the game, 1,500 definitely isn't.
Well, that's half.
I'm only joking.
Half, mate. Half of the gold difference. And with a Baron on top of everything.
Looks like we're going to see some more submarine play from Cedrian.
Yeah, it does take a huge amount of damage, actually, from Sanchez.
Just forces the flash outright, though. I mean, Sanchez doesn't even want to attempt... and engage. He may have been even able to kill Cedrian with the shockwave.
Never mind, eh? Magic Felix now looking for a 1v1 against Lipsian. Isn't going to be able to find it just yet, though. Obvious heading on down as well, and is going to be able to steal away this Grump. Excuse me. Bit of a hiccup coming on through there. Don't know why I'm commentating my hiccups. Lipsian jumps out once again, just trying to get some harass down.
Trying to siege onto this tier 2 in the bot lane. Phone's actually struggling now with Titanic Hydra and Black Cleaver against this very tanky Poppy. But Poppy is needed elsewhere as... Wow, Magi Felix going in!
Yeah, goodbye, Sanchez. Magi Felix doing so much damage. Even with the Shockwave, it's just not enough to keep him alive. Yopper looking for a flank, but there are four members there. I'm not sure this is going to go all too well for Yopper. He still has... I mean, the guy is so, so tanky in these fights. He literally takes no damage, but in the meantime, Phones is on the back line. He's managed to find Rafa. He's going to run away, or Skarl is at least, but Phones keeping alive. Noxiac keeping him shielded on that one. And now Magic Phoenix. Oh, perfect timing on the jump. Yopper charges, immediately presses S in a moment of pure tilt.
He did flash.
So, oh, did he flash? He I thought flashed, it was his heroic charge.
He flashed, so you can imagine why he might be slightly tilted after that play.
I'd be fuming.
Anyway, look at the Iron Solari and Athene's on Holy Grail now, therefore, obvious. So you have that healing potential on the key targets too. Obvious and Magi Felix now trying to go after Eco.
Yeah, I fear you may be in trouble, Eco. He's going to go down. Magi Felix grabs his 10th kill of the game. Almost disappointed he didn't go for Magi's at this point. Phones in trouble. The shield is not going to be enough as Yopper gets another kill for himself. In fact, it was Livsian who will finally go down as Magic Felix is sweeping up these fights, getting the resets and getting even more gold for himself. Cedrian to get credit for that final kill there. 22-10 is the score. Absolute bloodbath right now between ESG and ROG.
Over one kill a minute now, but then you kind of expected this from the potential draft phase that we saw between these two, so I'm not surprised that we're seeing a game that's descended into madness almost, but it looks like Euronix Gaming are absolutely used to this type of play, and they...
yeah.
And that sounds bad, but it's not, because they're winning.
This is a fiesta of the clowniest variety. Now, Econator is looking for a way in. Can't quite land this wave. Surely inhibitors should be dropping right now, since people are still dead. And to be honest, I don't see a scenario where Aces ROG win that fight anyway.
Do you know what's happened? This game is so intense that even Skype agrees and keeps dropping some sort of cool.
That's actually just the sound effects from Ivan with that skin.
Oh, my word.
It sounds like Rayman, I think.
Really? I thought it sounded like Skype.
It's when his trigger seed pops.
It's like, whoop. It's like, yeah, it's like this. You know when the Skype drops through and goes, whoop. Sounds like the Ivan trigger. So I was getting ahead of myself there.
Yeah, it's Ivan. It's Ivan. That skin has some odd sound effects to it, but...
As you can see, this is how where the commentary has descended to.
Phones actually getting locked up here. He's not very tanky at all. Knock up onto a few. Daisy on the front line trying to tank up, but it's Econators to grab the first kill of the fight. Cedrian fairly low, as well as Noxiac. And Yopper, who has been, honestly, a shining beacon of light for Aces ROG in this game so far. He's been so difficult for them to deal with. He's going to be heading up towards this top lane. Should be able to clear away the minion waves. Livsian has found Noxiac out in the end. That kill's going to go the way of Sanchez. And obvious will drop as well. Yopper getting himself a bit of kill credit. A good couple of kills coming through. And the inhibitors still remain.
Infernal Drake is up right now too. And with Magi Felix backing on a ward here, could Eco find the Q? Yes, he can.
Just be careful, Eco, because that's not a 1v1 that you can win. And... Magic Phoenix almost committing there. Will actually get stunned against the wall by Yopper, who... Yopper definitely cannot die at this point in the game, especially 1v1. And now Magic Phoenix in a bit of trouble. Is going to get buffed up by his Maw, but it's not enough to keep him alive. Livsian grabs the kill. Surely the Drake goes the way of Aces ROG if they can get this one quickly. Obvious, nowhere to be seen in Econators. Will have that smite available. Livsian, though, starting even more fights. Look at the damage onto Cedrian, but Phones... returning that comfortably.
Yeah, but looks like Infernal Drake should go over to Eco. Yopper there as that big front line. Actually going to back out here because the rest of ESG have turned up. This is your one victory, Aces ROG. Don't let it slip.
Yopper still battling away on that front line right now. Lucian still not going to be around for another 25 seconds. Can we see a steal come on through? No, we can't, is the answer. Obvious. Grabs that one for himself. I feel like if Livsian had just headed with his team to Dragon, they would have grabbed that one, to be honest. But I think he wanted the kill on Cedrian. Cedrian's been getting away with a lot this game. 7-2 and 6. Here comes Bones charging on. Immediately knocked away. Noxiac now on this front line. Actually tanking the tower as well. The invulnerability will pull him safely. It's not a tower. It's actually just a large plant. But... Yopper walking on forwards.
That's a distinction that's hard to make, right?
There goes Noxiac on this one. Daisy rooted up. Will be finished off shortly. Yopper getting a double knock-up here. Phones may well be the target, but Yopper then immediately knocks him away. Nice shockwave. Cedrian goes down. This could be a good fight for Aces. Magic Felix will get a reset though, and now he's looking for Rafa as well. Will get the double kill, and he's looking for more as well. Yoppa's incredibly low, but they just don't do enough damage to finish him off. And actually, that's another kill. This is going to be going the way of Euronics surely at this rate. Livsian, the last man remaining. Obvious Magic Felix and Phones. The three Musketeers pushing forward for the Inhibitors.
And it's a Triforce on the Katarina now. They have got some AD here behind them, so they should be able to get two Inhibitors comfortably off the back of that engage. Some baiting coming out from Livsian here. He's going back in.
Yeah, but will he survive? That is going to be the question. Magic Felix doesn't want to let him get away, but he doesn't have a choice. The Inhibitor does go down in the mid lane, so pressure coming out across the map. And trying to defend the tower is Noxiac doing his very best and will be able to protect it in the end.
By the way, just as a off topic, this might be one of almost, apart from Ace right up in, you know, that bit, that might be one of my favourite phrases you ever said. That's not a tower, that's just a giant plant.
It was a giant plant. I can't say I'm wrong.
You weren't wrong.
Well, teleport actually going to be channeled here by Phones. He's looking to start a fight onto Aziz Rog. Livsian trying to land onto Obvious, but needs to be careful on his targeting at this point. Magic Felix trying to take Wolves, but this is not the time for Wolves right now, my friend. There is fighting afoot, and you must participate.
I don't know, if I was training for a fight, I'd probably brawl with Wolves.
Yeah, but there's a difference between training and actually being in the fight.
True.
Well, redemption used here just for a little bit of sustain, or in fact, I think it was an enemy redemption, but either way, Yoppa charges on in. There's a first kill for Sentry.
Look at that damage!
Just about escapes with his life. Four-man shockwave, but there's just no follow-up available. Rafa was the only one to go down for Rog so far. Yoppa now falls, since he was stood in between five people and a daisy. Now, Baron will surely be on the cards for Euronics. Can we see a miracle steal? It certainly doesn't feel hopeful.
Well, we've seen it before. Eco has the ability to get across. He does go in here. They're going to take him down. He does go down. This should
be Baron. It was a bold play, Cotton. And we saw whether it paid off. It did not. He goes down. Baron picked up by ESG.
I think
that should be just about enough to secure the game at this stage for Euronics. With this Baron buff, they should be able to finish off those last Inhibitors and potentially just straight up walk into the Nexus. Got to give a little bit of a shout out to Obvious right now. 21 out of the 30 kills he's participated in on the Ivan. Just a single death. He has been all over the map and he's been very influential.
He has indeed. Really good game on Ivan. But then as has Magi Felix, really, 19 out of the 30 there. He's had a pretty solid game. I mean, everybody from ESG to an extent has stepped up in this game that required, you know, a very different approach to what we've seen from our classic games.
That is one way of saying it, absolutely. Phones now pushing down in this bottom lane. In the meantime, the rest of his team are going to be heading towards the mid lane, or actually, I think rotating down. They all want to stick as a unit and grab one of these Inhibitors together. Yoppa actually just straight up starting to fight with Daisy at this point as the Inhibitor slowly but surely getting taken on out. This is going to be the first one dropping, and now they'll rotate possibly to the mid lane, possibly just straight up look for the Nexus. This could be the cusp, the beginning of the end right now for Aziz Rog. Euronics pushing on forwards. Yoppa going to be the target. It's very tanky though as Cedrian grabs a kill onto Rafa. Shockwave onto a few, but Cedrian finds himself a double. Will be able to finish off Yoppa as well. It's in fact Obvious that gets that one for himself. And obviously this is going to be the game. Euronics managed to take it in the end. I was going to say, and what a game. An interesting game for sure between those two teams. And Euronics, the German squad, do manage to grab it.
Again, no impact on the group standings, however. Euronics just leave with a little more pride. Sona's kind of shaking his head there.
I haven't even turned on my mic. That's how little I want to talk about that previous game. Can we just move on to TLR versus Team Kinguin and talk about the next game instead?
Tell you what, if you don't want to analyze that game, fair play. Well done, Euronics.
I've been trying all game.
Unfortunately, Aziz Rog don't manage to get that one. Was a little bit of a clan fiesta. We're going to go into a quick break. Thank you once again to our sponsors, Alienware and AOC. Head over to esl.pm/Alienware if you want to grab yourself a little bit of kit. You can get laptops, PCs, all of that good stuff. And I believe there's some sales going on right now. You can also head over to esl.pm/AOC where we're running a competition. You can win yourself a 24-inch 165Hz monitor. So get over there and get involved. We're going for a quick break and we'll be back in a few.